Hey guys, so I've been using this terminal called WezTerm for a couple of days now, and it's been working very well for me so far. I will do a configuration for today, showing you how I'm gonna write the configuration for my terminal itself. The configuration is using the Lua language, and if you haven't, you can install WezTerm here in their website. So it supports Windows, Mac, Linux, so most of the platforms out there, it's being supported. So once you download that, you can maybe check out the features they have. They have a couple of nice features like multiplex terminal planes, tabs, windows, ligatures, hyperlinks, and all that good stuff. So I'm going to show you how I'm going to configure my terminal, and maybe you guys would be interested to follow along as well. So if you guys go into the configure section here, basically to actually configure WezTerm itself, all you need to do is create a Lua file. So in the home directory here, let's copy that. And I already have WezTerm up and running right here. So just use your favorite editor and edit your WezTerm Lua. So as you can see, I already have like a basic Lua table, returning a Lua table here. And if you don't know Lua, it's alright. It's a simple language, so don't be scared of it. Yeah. And in the beginning, we can just follow along the steps here. There's like 11 steps for you to actually configure your terminal itself. So we can start with the very first one, which is like launching your preferred shell in your terminal. So in the example here, it is showing that their default shell is the fish shell. So what we can do is actually we can just copy this here. And the path they use is so it's your own path here. So to actually know what your own path is, you can actually just check using the which command. So which fish, if you have fish shell installed, that is, or if you want to use bash, you can do use which bash, or if you prefer zsh, you can do which zsh. So I'm going to use fish, so I'm going to copy this path here, and then just paste it here, like so. The dash L flag will be automatically added by WezTerm, so I can just remove that. Then once I save this, WezTerm has like a auto load feature, so once you save the file, it will auto apply the changes. So if I close this tab here and open a new tab, you will see the fish shell is actually running now, and you can see like auto completion from the fish shell itself, which is really nice. The next part is like configuring the font itself. So configure font, all you have to do is just maybe you can just copy this here. And so in the example, it's using the Fira code font, but I actually have like my own font I want to apply, so it's a Fura code font here. And if I save this file, you'll see the font gets applied to even in my editor here right now. So if you can see, like there's a flash going on, and my font is now the Fura code font, which actually like supports ligatures and stuff. So if I do like greater than equal, you can see like there's like a ligature going on. As you can see, my screen is becoming smaller now. But the next thing we want to configure is actually the font size. So I'm going to add the font size here. So I'm going to put 18. And then when I save it, it will actually increase the font size of my entire screen here. And so after the font size, what I actually want to configure is the theme itself. So the theme of your terminal, you can see it's currently like a black background, green cursor and stuff. So to actually configure your theme, you can actually go to the color schemes directory here. Just click on that. And then as you can see, like there's like a bunch of themes you can actually choose from. So it will be sorted by characters here, alphabets. And there's like 735 themes. So I have a theme that I prefer, which is the oceanic material. So all you have to do is just copy the code snippet here and then go back to WezTerm, edit your WezTerm file, and then add your theme like so. As you can see, my background has changed and it has applied the theme. We also can see like the tabs font is a bit small here. So we also can actually adjust the font size of the font in the tab itself. All you have to do is create a window frame, and the window frame accepts a table. And inside the table, you can also specify the font size itself. So I'm gonna do 16 points for the font size. And once I save the file, you can actually see the font of the tab itself becoming big. So I like my tabs to be located at the bottom of my window itself. We also can do that with the configuration by just specifying tab bar at bottom. So as you can see, the tab bar has moved to the bottom. You also see like there's a bit of padding going on the side, inside the window itself. We can remove or adjust its padding by specifying the window padding table. So you can specify all the directions. So in this case, I want them to all be zero. So left, right, bottom, and top to all be zero. Once I save the file, you can see the padding has disappeared. So in the final part of the video, we're gonna add a few key bindings to our configuration. And the key bindings, out of the box, they are already a bunch of key bindings given by the configuration. But specifically, what I want is to add my old key bindings from my TMux configuration to WezTerm. Because basically, WezTerm comes out of the box with very similar features to TMux. And to actually add a key binding, we can actually look at the documentation here. Key binding documentation, and it actually shows us how to add the key bindings, which is adding a table within the table like so, and then specifying the keys, the modifiers, and the actions itself. So the first key binding I'm gonna add is actually splitting the terminal pane into horizontally, so that basically there's a line in the middle where I can have two terminals in one window or one tab itself. So what I can do is I need to specify the key, which is S, and the mods, which is alternate, or in Windows, or that's in Windows land, in Mac it will be option, and then the action itself will be WezTerm.action.split. And then the direction goes to right, and the size will be in percentage 50. Right, so I can save that, And once I press the key combination, it will actually split the pane here, as you can see. And I basically have two panes working together. So I can close this pane now. And I actually want another key mapping for my vertical split. So I can do split down, and I can show you guys the example of adding like multiple modifiers in this case. So to add multiple modifiers, all you need to add is like a pipe and then shift. And can do the keyboard key combination here. So it's like option shift S. So you have like a vertical split and 50% of the screen. So I also want another key mapping for actually closing one of the screens inside the tab itself. So I would like to assign that to the X key. And the action will be called close current pane. And the command confirm is false. Save that. And I can split vertically. And if I press option X, it will actually close it for me. The documentation for the actions in WezTerm itself can be found in the documentation. So if you were to go to available key assignments, you can actually see all the commands you can use for the action method itself. So the final two key mappings I'm gonna add is actually to rotate between the panes itself, either clockwise or anti-clockwise. So I'm gonna add another key binding here. And if I can just copy that. So I want to use maybe the L key here. So if I press Ctrl L, it will actually rotate between the panes itself. And the action will be called activate pane direction. Function, and it accepts a string, which is next. And I'm just gonna add the other one quickly. So Control Shift L would be to activate the pane direction on the previous one. And if I save that, so if I split my pane now, I'll split my multiple, and I press Ctrl L, you can actually see I'm rotating between the planes itself. Can even do four panes and do counterclockwise, clockwise. Yeah, which is pretty cool. That's all for the video. If you like the video, like it. If you want to subscribe, yeah, please do subscribe. And I'll see you on the next one.